Yes, good evening all. Now we are going to discuss in this lecture about remaining rules, fundamental formulas in limits. In the previous video, I discussed three fundamental limit rules in the limits. Now the fourth one, limit extending to a k f of x. Whenever you have limit extending to a k f of x, this k is a constant, k can come out. I can write as k into limit extend to a f of x. For example, suppose you have like this limit extending to pi by 4, you have 2 sin x, you have like this. So limit extending to pi by 4, 2 sin x you have. Then what I can do here, 2 I can take out common, out. 2 is a constant I can take out from the limit. So limit extending to pi by 4, I can write sin x. It means that 2 into sin pi by 4, you can substitute here. Sin pi by 4 is how much? 1 by root 2. So 2 by root 2. So it is cancel out root 2 times. So root 2 will be the answer. So what I want to tell you here is, whenever you have k, limit extends to a k f of x, then the k will come out and then you get limit extends to a f of x. So where k is a constant, where k is what? Constant. Okay, let's see another one also. The previous one also I'll explain one example, with example I'll explain. Okay, with examples previous one also I'll explain. Like here, previous video you have seen that, see, limit x, this is the rule is given. Okay, again I'll explain. Limit extending to a k into f of x, whenever you have, we can write as k into limit extending to a f of x, and this value they given L, so I can get as kL is the answer, because this limit extends to a f of x, they given L, that's where kL will be the answer for this. Okay, this is the fourth property. What is the fifth property? I explained, right? Already first property I explained. Suppose you have limit extending to a, suppose you are limit extending to, let us take limit extending to limit extending to 2, you have x square plus log x, you have like this x square plus log x. So I can write this as limit extending to 2 x square plus limit extending to 2 log x, means we can separate like this. This is what the first property, the previous video I explained. So limit extending to 2 f of x plus g of x is there, we can separate that. If f of x, here you have minus, then you can separate with minus. That's what I explained. Okay, if you have in multiplication also, like you have, suppose limit extending to pi by 4, you have log x into sin x. Then I can write what here? I can separate here, limit extending to pi by 4, log x into limit extending to pi by 4, sin x I can use as the previous property number 2. Okay, likewise what I want to tell you here, whenever you have like this, so we can use it. Third property, what I was explained, third property was limit extending to a, suppose you have log x by something, you have something, sir, you just take as x power n minus a power n. So what I can write here, limit extending to a log x by limit extending to a x power n minus a power n. This is what I explained in the previous lecture. This is what there in the previous lecture. Okay, fourth property you understood. K is there, means k will come out. Now here fifth property. Fifth property is that limit extending to a f of x power g of x, whenever you have f of x power g of x. There are, these methods are very important. Future, that is different, this is different, which I am going to explain, that is different and this is different. Limit extending to f of x power g of x is there, provided if f of x is greater than 0, if this is f of x is greater than 0, I can write limit extends to a f of x. I can find what is the limit for extending to a f of x, that is L. I can write L. And limit extending to a g of x, what is the value of limit extending to a g of x, that is m. So I can write L power m if x is greater than 0. But there is one more property you have, in future you will get, that is limit extending to, extending to a f of x power g of x. Whenever you have 1 power infinity form, that problems are different, that is very important for IIT, I will explain that later. Okay, now sixth one is limit extending to f circle g of x whenever you have. So f, I can break the circle, f break limit extending to a g of x it goes. Means f circle g of x whenever you have, limit will goes for this g function, not for the f function. So f of, we can write as f of limit extending to a g of x, I can write. And already you know that limit extending to a g of x value is how much? M. So I can write f of m, provided f of x is continuous function. It should be continuous function at a g of x is equal to m. Okay, it should be continuous function. When the questions comes, at that time I will explain. Okay. Now, another one is sixth property, that is limit extending to a log of f of x. So log of f of x, when log of x, not f of x. Suppose you have limit extending to a log of f of x, then you can write as limit extending to a log of f of x. Whenever you have log of f of x, then you can write as limit can be shared to this f of x. So I can write log of, and in the place of f of x, I can write limit extending to a f of x. So here, limit will be limit extending to a log of f of x will goes log of limit extending to a f of x, means this limit will goes to f of x. Okay, so here this value is already L, so I get as log L. So these are properties. Okay, these are properties. A final one, limit extending to a e power f of x whenever you have, we can write as e power limit extending to a f of x, means limit goes to the power. So I get as e to the power of L, I'll get e to the power of L. For example, I can say limit extending to a e power, suppose limit extending to pi by 2 e power sin x you have. So what I can write here, this is equal to, I can write as e power limit extending to pi by 2 sin x, I can write. It means I can write what here, e to the power of sin pi by 2, substitute the limit. Sin pi by 2 is how much? 1. So this value will become 1. E power 1 is 1. E power 1 is e. So answer is e. Like this we can do it. When you have logarithm, same. Here suppose, so for this one, seventh one example, suppose limit extending to a, extending to pi by 2, okay, extending to pi by 2, log sin x you have, suppose. Log sin x. I want to find the limit for this. So what I can write here, this is equal to limit, I can write as log limit extending to pi by 2 sin x, I can write. It means here I can write as log this extending to pi by 2, I substitute in the limit, so sin pi by 2 I'll get. So that is log sin pi by 2 value 1, log 1 value 0. 0 is the answer. So like that we will do it. Okay, this is the way we will apply the properties. Okay, these are the 8 properties. In previous lecture, I explained 3 properties. In this lecture, 5 properties, total 8 properties. Now you are going to learn standard formulas. Very, very important concept.